Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making hot butterscotch punch. It's getting to be the time of year when occasionally there'll be a cool morning, a little nippy outside. That's the time when you want to use something like hot butterscotch punch. I want to point out that I do have hot butterscotch in Betty's Kitchen, kind of like hot chocolate, only it's a butterscotch flavor. So this is a different recipe. It's more of a punch because it has a lot of milk in it. But it starts out by making a caramel sauce, and then we add milk to that. And it's really very quick and very easy to do. So we start with a saucepan on the stove, and I'll turn the stove on. And to that saucepan, I'm going to add 1/2 cup cream. Now this can be half and half, and that happens to be what I'm using here. And to that we're adding some dark brown sugar. So this is 1 cup of dark brown sugar. And I'm going to stir those together. Bring the heat up just a slight amount. Stir this and keep stirring until this boils. This is what gives a wonderful flavor to the punch. Our butterscotch sauce is boiling. I always bring this to a rolling boil, and then I add milk. So I'm going to turn this down, and we're going to add 4 cups of milk of your choice. This is 2% milk, but you can use skim milk. You can use full fat milk. But pour that in, and then stand here and stir until this becomes heated again. It can come just to the point of boiling, but it doesn't have to boil. We want it hot though. So bring the heat back up and stir. Our butterscotch punch is done, just about. We need to let it cool before we drink it, but it's very hot. And you can see when it foams like this and gets bubbles around the edges, it has been reheated. And we're going to turn the stove off, and I'm going to remove this from the stove and put it on a pad and just let it sit for about 10 minutes, because obviously that would be too hot to drink, but you don't want it to cool off until it's not a nice warm drink. Here we have our hot butterscotch punch. And I have let it cool for 10 to 15 minutes. I don't want it cold, although you can, after you have tried it warm or hot, you can let it cool down and actually chill it and have a chilled drink later. That's fine. But I like to grab it while it's hot, but I have to let it cool enough that it won't break my punch bowl. And also, you don't want it so hot that it would burn people's mouths. So that's the reason for waiting a little bit. But then you can pour it in your punch bowl, or if you have a pitcher that you want to put it in, just make sure that it's something that would not have a tendency to break if something hot is put in. You can probably see the steam. So it's hot enough for me to feel like I'm having something as hot as coffee, but it's going to be a nice butterscotch flavor. I'm just going to take a ladle and 1 of the cups that go with my punch bowl set and ladle into my cup about that much, or whatever you think is nice, and you can keep them all the same. And I'm going to actually place this over here for my serving, and then I'm going to be filling up the others so you can see the full display. I have all of my punch mugs filled, and I'm going to take a taste. So this is a nice looking butterscotch. It's nice and tan looking. And very warm, but not hot at this point. With all that manipulation of filling the different cups, it took enough time that any 1 cup has cooled. So it's a very good taste. It's just a warm taste. It's something that you would want if it's cold outside. I think you will enjoy it. Some of you might like to put a little rum in here and have a butter rum flavor for your punch. That would be great. Just put it to your taste. I hope you enjoy this recipe.